Hi everyone, I hope you're enjoying Build. My name is Stephanie and I'm a program manager on the Microsoft Edge Developer Experiences team. And today I'm going to be talking about some exciting new web tech. I'm going to be talking about dual screen devices and how you can start designing and building for them today with some new web primitives that have been introduced into the web platform. So today we're going to touch on a few different things. We're going to briefly discuss responsive design before diving into the CSS Media query feature, the JavaScript API, an example, and then talk about how you can test for dual screen even if you don't have a physical device. Now, we can't really talk about designing for dual screen devices without talking about responsive design. Responsive design refers to a design that's implemented in such a way that it responds to the environment it's being viewed on. So it adapts and shifts depending on what device you're on. And that includes this new class of device. With dual screen devices, we want developers to view it as the next step in responsive design. And on the Edge team, we wanted to make sure we could empower developers to do just that and take advantage of dual screen devices and enable them to deliver enhanced experiences. Our web platform team has worked hard in conjunction with community groups to deliver two new web APIs for web layout that were nearly impossible when Microsoft announced its Surface Duo and when other foldable devices hit the market. The team designed, proposed, and implemented a CSS screen-spanning media feature query and the JavaScript Windows Segments Enumeration API to make dual-screen enhanced layouts possible. Now, these are APIs that are in development, and we've been working with the community through origin trials to gather feedback and have made some updates, which I'll discuss in each API section as the code has changed, as well as where the APIs live. So let's dive into the CSS Media feature query first. So dual screens are just the next step in responsive design. So we view it as another responsive design target. Just as you use media queries in your CSS today to detect and serve styles specific to phones, tablets, and desktop screens, you can use a media query to detect this new class of device. We initially proposed a new screen-spanning media query, but after feedback from the community on supporting future multi-fold devices, we've moved on with an update to align with the current concept of viewports. The viewport segment media query can have two values. One is horizontal viewport segments, followed by an integer, and this represents the state of the device when the device hinge is vertical and the viewports are split by this hinge or fold into two columns. The second one is vertical viewport segments, again followed by an integer, and this represents the state of the device where the fold is horizontal and the two viewports are stacked and split into rows. So in this example, we're combining our horizontal viewport segments media query with another media query, min-width. So we're saying if the device has two viewport segments side by side and the viewport has a minimum width of 540 pixels, make the background of the body element yellow. So if we run this code on three different devices, the result will be that we get the yellow background only on our dual screen device. Now, some of our customers wanted to be able to snap their content to the fold of the device, which makes sense. On some devices, we do have this physical hinge that can break up content and even obscure it. So some wanted to avoid that hinge and place that content within the display region boundaries only. Now, with our current media query solution we just looked at, we can detect if the browser is spanning across two displays on a dual screen, but that's not currently enough. You could probably go on to assume that both screens are equal in size, but the team didn't want devs to have to do that because that won't necessarily scale on new devices. So we don't want to assume that both screens are equal. So let's look at the proposed solution for identifying the different displays and their sizes. On top of the media queries, the team has also introduced a set of predefined environment variables that will help with identifying the geometry of the fold. And when I say geometry, I mean the position and size relative to our client coordinates. So in this illustration, we know the origin, the 0, 0 point coordinates, and we know the 100 viewport width and the viewport height coordinates. So we have four new variables to help with this: fold top, fold left, fold height, and fold width. And using the calc function in CSS is how you can determine the size of each display region. You can see here on the device up to the left, from 0 to fold left is how wide the first display region is. And then fold width is the hinge, which is how much gap there is between the two columns or viewports. So these are all working drafts of proposals, so the code is currently subject to change. And one change we're in the midst of looking over is a change to the environment variables. And we would love the community's feedback on this work. So head over to aka.ms/env-variables, which will take you to a GitHub issue around the current thinking for this design update. Now let's talk about the JavaScript API. We initially proposed a new JavaScript API called Window Segments Enumeration. However, as the team spent more time with this and heard feedback from the community, it made more sense to add it on to the existing Visual Viewport API draft spec. Today, when you're on a desktop computer and you query visualviewport.segments, this will return null if there is only one viewport segment. On dual screen devices, however, you'll get two DOM recs representing the two viewports available when the browser window is spanning across the fold. Something quite important to mention here is the value that we have stored in the segments constant is an immutable snapshot of the device state at the time the attribute was queried, which means once you resize the browser window or rotate the device, the viewport segments previously retrieved are no longer valid, and you need to query this attribute again in either a resize event or an orientation change event. You can see when we change the viewport from spanning across two display regions to only one display region, we'll fire the resize event for you. And if you rotate the device, this will fire both the resize and the orientation change event. You can use these events to query the attribute again and see what the state of the browser is and what the display region's geometry is at this moment. Now, one question we get frequently is when should I use the CSS API or the JavaScript API? In some cases, there is no CSS, which can happen when you're working with shapes and objects in Canvas 2D and WebGL. So if you're building a game, for example, that could leverage both screens on a dual screen device or even a sketching app, you'll want to use the JavaScript API to get the geometry of the display regions. Another use case would be creating DOM elements at application runtime and appending them to the DOM and inserting some styles inline. In this case, maybe these styles would only be applicable for dual screens. And now let's look at an example using the CSS API. So our example here is a mail application on a dual screen device. And the example on the left, we can see that the layout is just slightly off. And due to the nature of the fold on this device, there is some content being obscured by the fold. So the experience on the right is what we want. So let's take a look at how we get there. Our first media query here is blank, but this is where you would put your rules specific to screens that are wider than a tablet. Our second media query is for our dual screen device tablet. So we're targeting devices that have a minimum width of 799 pixels and are in the vertical fold posture. So the viewports are two columns. Then when we go on to dig into the CSS here, the main element is wrapping the three columns of our email app. So we have the nav, the inbox, and the email content. For our navigation in this email app, our design spec says that the desired width for this is 60 pixels. And since we're using flex direction row, flex basis acts like this flex item's width. For our inbox, we want this to consume the entire width of the first display region, so our first screen, minus the width of the navigation. So we'd have our CSS calculate our width with the fold left environment variable, subtract 60 pixels. And then on some devices, we have that mask or that fold that is covered by part of the device hardware, so we need to add a margin after the column. So we go on to use margin inline end with the environment variable fold width, which will identify that gap. And then finally, for our email content, the email content should grow to fill the rest of the space. But to demonstrate how to calculate the width of the second display region, we'll manually set the width here. Now let's talk about testing. So for developers who don't have a dual screen device, that's okay. You can use the DevTools device emulator in Engine Chrome today on your Windows or your Mac machines to emulate this device and make sure your user interface is looking how it's supposed to on dual screen devices. If you don't see this, you can go to your DevTools settings and enable experimental Surface Duo emulation. And in this screenshot here, I'm editing the Microsoft Docs style sheet in DevTools to see how it could be adapted for the Surface Duo. If you dabble in app development as well as the web, you can install the Surface Duo emulator if you have the Android SDK installed. And this will allow you to test your dual screen website in Edge just as a customer would see it on their device. You can even use the DevTools in your desktop browser to connect and debug your content in the emulator's browser. Thanks for joining me for this quick overview of dual screen web development. For more information, check out the documentation and the Surface Duo team and Edge developer blogs on Twitter, and visit GitHub for open source code samples. And I hope you enjoy the rest of Microsoft Build 2021.